Hi there, and welcome back to Chemistry. My name is Jeremy Krug, and in this video, we're going to be talking about isotopes of atoms and how we write the formulas for those and talk about the symbols of these isotopes of atoms. By the way, if you're new here, take a look around, take a look at the playlist, some other lab demonstrations and other discussions on here. I think you'll like what you see. If you enjoy or learn something from this video, I'd like to encourage you to give me a thumbs up. I really do appreciate that. Now, as we take a look at isotopes, let's look at the atom that we have right here drawn in this picture. Now, we know this is not drawn to scale like we said in the last video, but this is just to help us look at and talk about the atom here. My first question is, how many protons do you see in this atom? Well, I hope you can count that there are 5 protons right there. Now, if we look at the periodic table, we know that because it has 5 protons, it has to be boron. Right? Everything that's boron has 5 protons. Everything that has 5 protons is boron. That's just how it is. It's like the fingerprint for an element, its number of protons. How many neutrons do we have here? Those are drawn in yellow, and we can see that there are 6 neutrons in this particular atom, right? Now, how many electrons do we have buzzing around? Well, we can count around in those energy levels and see that there are 5 electrons. Now, that matches up with what we talked about in our last lecture, where we said that the number of protons should be the same as the number of electrons in a neutral atom. Well, because of this, we're going to give this isotope a name. It's boron, but it's not just boron. It's specifically boron 11. We're going to call this boron 11. Now, the reason for that is we're going to take that total number of protons and neutrons and call that the mass number. So, you know, the atomic number is just like it was in our last video here. It's the number of protons, and the mass number is the number of protons and neutrons. So it had 5 protons and 6 neutrons, so that's a total of 11. So it's called boron 11. And the way that we write the symbol is, you write the symbol for the element, the mass number goes on the top as a superscript, and then the atomic number goes on the bottom here as a subscript written before the symbol. So boron 11. Now, let's take a look at this other symbol here, and let's see if we can determine the number of protons, electrons, and neutrons in this isotope. Well, the number of protons is determined by looking at the atomic number, isn't it? So it's 20. How many electrons? Well, any neutral atom should have the same number of protons as it has electrons, so it should also be 20. How about the number of neutrons? Well, once again, we have to subtract the top number minus the bottom number. So the mass number minus the atomic number. That's equal to 22, isn't it? So this particular version of calcium has 20 protons, 20 electrons, and 22 neutrons. Now, what's the name of this isotope? Well, once again, we have the name of the element with a little hyphen and then the mass number. So we're going to call this calcium 42. So that's the name of this particular isotope of calcium. Let's try another example. Let's try this isotope. Now, how many protons does it have? Well, the atomic number down here tells us that it has 6 protons, doesn't it? The number of electrons should be the same as the number of protons, so it's also going to be 6. And the number of neutrons is the difference between 14 minus 6, isn't it? So 14 minus 6 is 8. And so this has 6 protons, 6 electrons, 8 neutrons. And what do we call this? Well, carbon, the little hyphen, and then the mass number. So it's carbon 14. Now, you might remember that in the last video, we said that a typical atom of carbon has 6 protons, 6 electrons, and 6 neutrons. But in this one, we're saying this particular isotope has 6 protons, 6 electrons, and 8 neutrons. Well, that's because this is a different variety or a different isotope of this element. Now, different isotopes of an element are different from each other in the number of neutrons that they have. For example, there are 3 main isotopes of carbon. There's one that's the most common. It's called carbon 12, And it's, you know, very common. Over 99% of all carbon atoms have six neutrons in them. Well, there are about 1% of carbon atoms that have seven neutrons. We call that carbon 13. And then there's a very small trace percent of carbon out there that has eight neutrons, and that's called carbon 14. They're all carbon because they have the same six protons, but it's a different isotope because it has a different number of neutrons. It's kind of like apples. There are lots of different varieties of apples, aren't there? Maybe the most common one that you're thinking of would be a red apple, but there are other apples too, aren't there? And so there are lots of varieties, just like there are different varieties of an element. We call those isotopes. Let's try this one. This time we're going to have the name of the isotope, and we have to figure out some information about it. So how many protons are in an atom of neon 21? Well, for this one, we're going to have to consult the periodic table. And so neon has 10 protons, because you look at the table, and you see that Ne has an atomic number of 10. Now, if it has 10 protons, it's got to have 10 electrons too, doesn't it? So we have that. How many neutrons? Well, it's the mass number minus the atomic number, isn't it? So 21 minus 10. So that's 11 neutrons in this particular isotope of neon. Now, how would you write the symbol for that? Well, it would look like this, wouldn't it? The mass number goes on top as a superscript. The atomic number goes on the bottom as a subscript, and then you write the symbol, Ne. So this is how you'd write the symbol for neon 21. Let's try this. Let's write the symbol this time. Something with 16 protons, 16 electrons, and 20 neutrons. Well, if we consult the periodic table, we'll see that anything that has 16 protons has to be sulfur, isn't it? So the symbol is going to be S. Now, let's not just stop there. We need the numbers in there, too. So what's the number that's going to go on the bottom as the subscript? Well, that's going to be the atomic number, isn't it? So that's going to be the 16. And then the number that goes on top is going to be the mass number. That's the sum of the protons plus the neutrons for that particular atom. So 16 plus 20 is 36. And so that's the symbol for this isotope. And by the way, what's the name of this isotope? Well, once again, it's the name of the element, little hyphen, and then the mass number. So it's sulfur 36. And so that's how you'd write the name of this isotope. Let's try one more example. We'll write the symbol for this isotope as well. 38 protons, 38 electrons, 50 neutrons. Well, we can consult the periodic table and see that anything with 38 protons has to be strontium, isn't it? So the symbol is SR. Now, we need some numbers here. What number goes on the bottom? Well, that's going to be the atomic number, isn't it? The number of protons. So 38 goes on the bottom. What number goes on the top? Well, that's going to be the sum of protons and neutrons, isn't it? So 38 plus 50, so that's 88. That's going to go on the top. So that's our symbol, 88 over 38, SR. Now, what's the name of this isotope? Once again, it's the name, a hyphen, and the mass number. So this would be called strontium 88. That's the name of this isotope. I hope you learned something from this video. If you did, please smash that like button. I really appreciate it. That helps the algorithm. That helps other people find these videos as well. If you really like what you see, I really appreciate it when you subscribe as well. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time.